Hello students, we are going to discuss about mechanism or stages of crystallization. Stages or mechanism of crystallization. The formation of crystal from solution involves three steps. One is supersaturation, another one nucleation, third one crystal growth. One by one we will discuss. Supersaturation. What is supersaturation? It refers to a state in which the liquid contains more dissolved solid than can ordinarily be accommodated at that temperature. Most popular example, sodium acetate. Crystallization from a solution is an example of the creation of new phase within a homogeneous phase. So homogeneous means same phase. It occurs in two stages. One is nucleation, another one crystal growth. Driving force of crystallization is supersaturation. Without supersaturation, crystallization does not occur. Are you clear or not? Okay. This is nothing but concentration difference between that of the supersaturated solution in which the crystal is growing and that of the solution in equilibrium with the crystal. Supersaturation is generated by one or more of the following method. First one, by evaporation of the solvent, that is vaporization. Second one, by cooling. Third one, adding a third component which may combine with the original solvent to form a mixed solvent where the solubility of the solute is highly reduced. This is called salting. New solute may be created chemically by the addition of third component by the reaction between the original solute and the new third component. This is called precipitation. Supersaturation is defined delta Y is equal to Y minus OS, delta C is equal to C minus CS. Delta Y supersaturation, that is mole fraction of solute. Y is equal to mole fraction of solute in supersaturation solution. Ys is equal to mole fraction of solute in saturated solution. Whereas delta C, molar saturation, moles per unit volume. C is equal to molar concentration of solute in supersaturated solution. Cs is equal to molar concentration of solute in saturated solution. Supersaturation ratio, that is S, is defined the ratio between mole fraction of solute in supersaturated solution to mole fraction of solute in saturated solution. Effect of supersaturation differ in nucleation process and crystal growth process. Separation treatment of both processes necessary. Second mechanism, nucleation. Birth of very small bodies of molecule, this is called nucleation. Some clusters may become so big they may arrange themselves in lattice arrangement, that is structure. These bodies of aggregates are called embryos. This is the earlier stage. Embryos are unstable. They may break into cluster again. These stable structure together to form a nucleus. Types of nucleation. Nucleation classified into two types. One is primary nucleation, another one secondary nucleation. So here primary nucleation is nothing but formation of new crystal. Okay, so this is independent of the presence of other crystal in the medium. This is classified into two types. One is homogeneous, another one heterogeneous. What is homogeneous? Has its origin in clusters of solute molecules that form in a supersaturated solution. Whereas heterogeneous, formation of crystal of a solute on small suspended foreign solid particles or on the surface of the crystallizer. Second type of nucleation, secondary nucleation. What is secondary nucleation? Formation of new crystal from the existing one. This is secondary nucleation. Secondary nucleation classified into four types. One is contact, another one shear, third one fracture, fourth one attrition. One by one we will discuss. First one, contact nucleation. More nucleus formed by contact nucleation by fracture and attrition. Second one, shear nucleation. Shear nucleation, there is a high relative motion between liquid and crystal. They loosely order phase near the crystal surface. This is carried into bulk of the liquid. This is shear nucleation. Whereas fracture nucleation, crystal occurs by impact with the impeller. Attrition nucleation, small crystals are formed which grow to large size in the supersaturated solution. Stages of nucleation. First one, kinetic unit. Crystal nuclei may form from molecules, atoms or ions. Due to their rapid motion, these particles are called kinetic units. Are you clear or not? Okay. So, these kinetic units join together and also break frequently. When they are held together, they can also be joined by a third particle. Combination of these called cluster. Are you clear? Okay. So, this is the second stage. These clusters are also liable for break in their formation. When the number of kinetic units in a cluster is very large, it is called embryo. Are you clear? Okay. So, this is the earliest stage. They can also break into clusters or kinetic units. Depending on the level of supersaturation, the embryo grows and forms nucleus. Okay, sometimes this is stable or unstable. Okay. So the number of kinetic units in a nucleus is of the order of 100, and when the nuclei gain kinetic units, what is the result? The form of crystal. Are you clear or not? Okay. So these are the stages of nucleation. Third mechanism, crystal growth. Every crystal is surrounded by a layer of liquid is known as stagnant layer. Once the crystals are formed, nuclear formation starts and crystal growth begins. From the bulk solution, a solute particle diffuses through this stagnant layer, then reaches the surface of the crystal. These particles then organize themselves in the crystal lattice. That is a crystal structure. This phenomena continue at the surface at a slow rate. Mears supersaturation theory. So Mear and Isaac proposed a theory explaining a relationship between supersaturation and spontaneous crystallization. Mears theory points out degree of saturation is higher, more chances for nuclei formation. Supersaturation possesses a certain range of values, that is a range. Nuclei formation is extremely rapid. Thank you for your attention.